Oh, you thought I was talking to you?
Nope.
You knew you was little man?
No.
Huh? Oh, hey, that's the Rob report.
That's
huh?
The littlest man in the on the team right here.
That's the smallest man.
I think he weighed about 185. That's soaking wet.
Like, boy, I don't hit like it though. God, dog.
Hi, my Rob. Real Rob people.
We got VA in the house, man. VA. In the house.
Oh no, they're not. That Jose Bango, baby.
The real Rob.
Of course.
Oh my gosh. Hey guys.
Out of back.
Yeah,
oh, yeah. Now you came out of the back.
Hey, the real Rob, man. I've been missing you guys, man.
Traveled to New York. From the jump, it was a circus. It's like the president's moving around. Like, we got helicopter escorts, we got police escorts, motorcade, like it was crazy.
But it's a lot, and it's a lot of international media. They ask you questions to put you in a certain position to go viral.
As much as you want to just, I'm just focused on the game, you could not. At this point, it's like, you know, this is what we work for to get here. Like, we want to seize the opportunity, but you know, you also want to be able to live in the moment and experience what's going on.
Marshawn, can I get some of those Skittles?
Oh yeah, bro. Check this out.
Okay, well, okay.
This
what
that
are these?
That new right here.
That new new. Okay.
Just that new Seattle Skittle mix, though. You feel me?
Okay.
Hey, you the first to get them, bro.
Oh, I feel big time.
We're talking on Real Mike Rob Report. We're here at Media Day, about to have a good old time for about an hour talking to these media.
Man, don't talk to me like that ever again, man. That old robot answer, man.
I saw Beast Mode start shaking his leg as the questions were being asked.
Marshawn's just being Marshawn. Like, he don't feel like talking today. You know what I'm saying? Leave him alone. He doesn't feel like talking. All right, there's 52 other guys. Talk to those guys. You know what I mean?
You can clearly see he's frustrated. He's answering what he deems is a suitable answer. And you're still not happy enough.
Want me to take it? Huh? I take it.
I thought he was gonna flip the table.
I like when you got off the plane with the Beast Mode and everything. It looked like you're ready to play, man.
Yep, that's what time it is.
I just kept remembering, like, man, I just wanna get to the game. Like, this is too much.
You just don't wanna talk, really.
I'm just about that action, boss.
On the banks of the Hudson River, looking from New Jersey over to Manhattan as we get set for Super Bowl 48. And the wind down to Super Bowl 48 really kicked off today. Seahawks practicing at the Giants indoor facility, bringing a bit of normalcy to a week that is anything but normal.
I think those are probably the most fun practices we've had, especially once we got to New York. We were out there dancing.
The week of practice beforehand, I think it was the best week we've ever had. It was such a competitive practice. You know, most people, the average mindset would think, oh, well, let's not, you know, go too hard, not go too physical, we don't hurt each other. No, it was full go. That felt like our Super Bowl that week of practice.
Yeah, we were sitting in the New York Giants locker room and defensive room, and we looked up and we saw, like, what they had as standards. Oh, don't give up 120 rushing yards. Don't give up 215 passing yards. We got to see somebody else's, your standard. That became like, oh no, our standard was so much higher. And I thought when we saw that, it really kind of charged us up to really be like, bro, we're on a whole nother level of thinking.
And we started to watch Denver. We watched a quarter. And if you ever seen Beast Mode laugh, he laugh all, I mean, goes everywhere. There's goals everywhere, he tripping. And we look at each other, we like, bro, this might not be close.
And it really didn't matter who we was gonna play against. We knew we was gonna win.
I would say I was stressed until we watched the tape. If you look at the numbers and you're just, you know, you'd be lying if you just say, man, these numbers aren't staggering. Like, that's incredible. Like, I need to see what they were doing to people. And then you turn on the tape and you're like, oh, guys are just getting tired.
I remember looking at Sherman, like, oh yeah, we can play with these guys. Because the hype was, you know, they're the best team since sliced bread, like the best offense, and Peyton Manning.
They're taking advantage of fatigue. And Chris Richard, greatest quote, one of his great quotes, he's like, fatigue will make cowards of us all. Because when you're tired, you can never think straight. You can never make the right decision. You rarely ever feel like, hey, I can go chase this guy down or I can guard this guy. Like you lose all confidence when you're fatigued. So that whole first week, we were doing gassers, extra gassers after practice because we were like, y'all are not gonna run us off this field.
And I can remember walking into the training room and Earl Thomas always had such a special focus about him. And I saw him wave me over as he was getting taped. And he was the one that said to me, whatever you call today, it works. That's the confidence that he had, the focus that he had. And, you know, felt like my chest, you know, expanded. Just whatever you call today, it works. I'll remember that sentence for the rest of my life.
You know, we were there eating breakfast, watching TV, watching everything leading up to the game. And all the broadcasts were up there and they do their predictions and everybody picked the Broncos.
I remember that moment very specifically.
And then we both look at each other and just stare at each other, not saying anything at all, like no words, but you can hear them in, in your head what the words were.
Knowing who we have on this team, like I don't see a chance for these guys.
And then we just shook hands and said, let's go.
From MetLife Stadium in East Rutherford, New Jersey, it is Super Bowl 48 between the Seahawks and the Denver Broncos.
I love you, boy. Sir, sir, I love you. I love you too, E. Same old, same old. Champ, I love you, boy. Yeah, every fall. Let's go, bro. That's what we do. Ain't nobody can take that from us. If he take that from us, he can take our hearts. He can't take our hearts. He can't take it out of our chest. Too many of them. It's never about them. It's about us.
Hey, at the beginning of the year, I asked y'all boys, why not us? We're here for a reason. We're here for a reason. And let's go prove it tonight. Let's be explosive all night. Let's go take this win. Let's go get it, baby. Let's go to work. Here we go. Hawks on three. Hawks on three. One, two, three. Hawks.
This is the biggest game of their life. The Super Bowl doesn't get any bigger than this. Right, they're excited. Right, they're emotional. Right, they're ready to play.
We're not like everybody else. That's why we're so good, bro. Nobody in the world can beat us, bro.
We're made for this. We're made for this.
Wow. There is nothing like pregame for the Super Bowl.
Man, that's awesome, man.
Come on, just where we wanted to be, right?
Yeah, right here. Let's go take it now. Let's go take it. Let's go take it.
Yeah, right.
Well, Joe Namath actually flipped it a bit early.
I had a quick release.
I remember being struck going to it like, wow, there's a lot of Hawks fans here. There's a lot of Hawks energy in the house, and that would prove to be a deciding factor where the 12s played a big role.
This crowd is loud. Manning goes out of the shotgun a lot. Moreno to the left side. And the ball goes into the end zone. It's a flag down. Moreno dives for the ball. It should be a safety, but let's see.
So the first play of the game.
A safety. You know, it's just, it's like going downhill fast. Hey.
The play where Cam hit Demarius and like set the tone. Like, hey, guys, let you guys know, like, we're not here to F around with you.
Manning now shifts Decker over from left to right. Manning takes the snap out of the shotgun. Stands, looks, has time, dumps it underneath. And getting hit, and I mean hit hard as he caught the ball, Demarius Thomas by Cam Chancellor.
Yeah, it was in robber.
Pass is caught, big hit, Cam Chancellor.
That was a tone setter by Cam.
You know, that was one of those, don't throw that across the middle no more.
They don't even want to be here,
that's
bro.
Own it.
They don't want to be here, bro.
It's us.
I knew that Peyton was limited. I knew he couldn't run. And I knew my D-line was fast as I don't know what and disruptive. So I believed in my guys more than I believed in Peyton Manning.
Shotgun snap. Manning makes it. He steps up in the pocket on the blitz. Ball sails. Ball's intercepted at the 40-yard line. Cam Chancellor. Ball was kind of a duck. I don't know if it got touched.
Yes, yes, we got it. Hey, they can get it. Yes. L.O.B. L.O.B. L.O.B.
Well, after that first hit, I'm just thinking, like, just tearing everybody off. But I look up last minute, it's just popping in my hands, and I catch him. Oh, okay.
Now flying across the formation, taking the handoff right to left, Percy Harvin gets a block, turns upfield 30, knocked out of bounds inside the 25.
Lord have mercy! It's Percy.
I like handing the ball off, boys. Hand off to the big fella.
Wilson under center. The turn, the hand to Lynch, looks for running room. puts his head down. He keeps running, he's in! Touchdown, Seahawks! The Seahawks stretch their lead over the Denver Broncos.
LaShawn, I see you eating them Skittles. I see you, baby.
Is it all right if we score more points?
Oh, yeah, we can score some more. We can score some more. We don't need some more.
Can we?
Yeah, you can.
All right.
We can, we
I
will.
I just wanted to make sure.
We will.
Three receivers near side, batting out of the shotgun. 35. Moreno in the backfield. Now he scampers. The ball is hit as it comes out, and it's picked off by the Seahawks. Far sideline, Malcolm Smith. 50, 45, and 30. 30, all in the touch. Cut back, 20, 10. Region of Boom, the Seahawks defense. They do it again. Holy catfish.
Whooping their ass. They think we're going to get scared of them. We're going to eat their heart.
Let's show Cliff some love right here, too. I know Cliff like getting his love.
This is actually one of the few games that Mike and I got to start. It was the Super Bowl game because of the personnel that they came out in.
And Cliff bullies the tackle. He bullies the tackle right into his pocket. And we always teach attack the elbow. Extend your arm out, and Malcolm right there, right place, right time. People don't talk about this celebration enough. He goes for the dunk slash layup slash, I don't know what this was, dog. But I gave it a D minus.
What do I do? Huh?
Hell of a game by Malcolm.
You'd think we were in Seattle. 30 minutes left to play from a huge Super Bowl victory.
Next time on Season of Boom.
The first half went really well, but we weren't resting on that.
Short kick. Percy Harvin with the catch.
He was running so fast, and I thought the police was really coming after him. I think I started running a little bit too.
Oh man, it was epic.
What kind of message did this send?
Oh, rubber. Oh yeah, that was it was in rubber. Robert right there, man, coverage, and you know, that was one of those, don't throw that across the middle no more. You know, it's one of us was going to deliver a big blow, and it just happened to be me that started it off. But that was that message, like, hey, we came to play. Anybody that touched this ball is going to feel it, and we're here to do business. We're here to win this game. So this is just a little preview right here of what the rest of the game is going to feel like.